Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech, and today it's Fishbowl Thursday, and we have a spicy modern list to look at. This one comes to us from Metatech, and it's a really different, kind of janky, but really cool take on Morophon, the Boundless Bringers, and super excited to show off this deck. Thank you to Metatech for sending in the deck, and if you'd like your own deck considered for a future Fishbowl Thursday, leave me a link in the comments or email me, saffronolive@mtggoldfish.com. So let's talk Boundless Bringer for Modern, starting with the card that makes it all happen. We are a Morophon the Boundless deck, and you probably know what Morophon does. It's 7 mana, it's a changeling, so it's every creature type, which is really important. When it comes into play, we choose a creature type, and then spells of the chosen type cost 1 of every color of mana less to cast. So if it's a 5-color card, it's essentially free, and it gives those creatures +1/+1. So what are we doing in Morophon the Boundless? Number one is, we're playing Modern. 7 mana is a lot. We need to find Morophon, because it's a unique effect. There aren't other replacement Morophons in the format, so we need to find it consistently, and we need to get it on the battlefield quicker than just tapping 7 mana for it. So, for finding Morophon, we have Flamekin Harbinger. It tutors for an elemental. Thankfully, Morophon, every creature type, so it tutors for Morophon. This is actually the only card that it can get in our deck, is Morophon the Boundless, but Flamekin just puts it on top of our deck, so essentially copies 5, 6, 7, and 8 of Morophon the Boundless. Then, for getting Morophon the Boundless into play earlier, we got a few options. Warren Instigator, when it hits our opponent, we can put a goblin into play. Well, since Morophon is a changeling in every creature type, it's technically a goblin, so this can get Morophon into play as early as turn 3. Preeminent Captain, same thing but for soldiers. If it attacks, we can put a soldier into play tapped and attacking Morophon. Why it's a goblin, it's also a soldier, so we can stick it into play for free. And then we have Sorophon, Imperious Bloodlord, which can -3 to put a vampire into play from our hand. Morophon, along with being a goblin and a soldier, is also a vampire, so we can just stick it into play there as well. So this gives us 8 copies of Morophon. It gives us 12 ways to put Morophon into play by turn 3. What are we doing once we get Morophon on the battlefield? And this is where the deck's kind of funny and janky. So our big top-end threats are the Bringer cycle. So the Bringers, there was this weird cycle, 1 for each color from 5th on. They're 9 mana, except you can pay 1 of each color instead of their mana cost, which means all of a sudden these cards are free. Once Morophon hits the battlefield, we can play any Bringers we have from our hand for free. They're all 5/5s with additional abilities, and they allow us to do sweet things on our upkeep. For example, Bringer of the Blue Dawn on our upkeep lets us draw 2 cards, which is going to find us more Bringers. Bringer of the Black Dawn allows us to Vampiric Tutor, tutor for a card, put it on top of our library. So with the help of Bringer of the Blue Dawn, we can tutor first, get another Bringer, put the Bringer on top of our deck. So we're just going to keep stacking up Bringers for free on the battlefield once you have Morophon. Then we have a couple of one-of Bringers, which are more tutor targets for our Black Bringer. Bringer of the Green Dawn gets us a Beast Token each upkeep. Bringer of the Red Dawn can yoink one of our opponent's creatures for the turn each upkeep. So this gives us a ton of big, powerful creatures to just come down for free. So the idea is, we find Morophon by turn 2. By turn 3, we're putting Morophon into play. Then we're just casting a bunch of Bringers for free, getting all this upkeep value again and again and again and again. That is the plan in the core of the deck. Otherwise, we got 1 Simian Spirit Guide. I don't know what 1 Simian Spirit Guide really does. I guess if you happen to have it, you can get your Warren Instigator down a turn early or something. A little bit weird, though. Normally, you want a bunch of Simian Spirit Guides or no Simian Spirit Guides. 1 is the strangest number I've ever seen. Otherwise, for interaction, we got Thought Seizes, Fatal Push, Path to Exile, pretty typical modern stuff. The mana base, we're not going to talk about all of it. I will tell you that the idea is, if we don't have Morophon, we have a bunch of Fetchlands, Shocklands, some other random lands, basic lands, because we do want to be able to get 1 mana of each color on the battlefield to just hard cast Bringers for 5 mana. So that is our backup plan if something goes wrong. So that's the focus of the mana base. Check out the full deck if you want to see the whole pile of like 20 different dual lands in the format. Sideboard wise, we get a bunch of removal. Engineer Explosive, Anger of the Gods for sweepers, Path, Colgan's Command, target a removal, Colgan's Command can get back a Bringer from the graveyard, Wear Tear for artifacts and enchantments, Shenanigans, repeatable artifact destruction, and then a bunch of targeted hate. Alpine Moon for Trons and Valakut, Stony Silence for artifacts, Rest in Peace for graveyards, Ashiok, same deal, graveyards, as well as just shutting down fetch lands. And that is Boundless Bringer for Modern. And that's been our Fishbowl Thursday Instant Deck Tech for this week. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it. Thanks again to Metatech for sending in. And oh yeah, if you want your own deck considered for a future Fishbowl Thursday, make sure to leave me that link in the comments or email me, saffronolive@mtggoldfish.com. Thanks for watching. Again, I hope you enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon. If you enjoyed today's deck, make sure to purchase it from our sponsor, Card Kingdom. For a limited time, you can get a Scoop Soldier sticker for free if you mention Scoop Soldier in your order notes during checkout.
Thanks for watching the video! If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.